Addressing a media conference at Christ the King Cathedral in Nakuru, Homa Bay Catholic Diocese Bishop Philip Agnolo outlined that the national dialogue will endeavor to build trust among political players. Mombasa Bishop Martin Kivuva also noted that the forum will focus on contentious electoral issues and possible gaps in the constitution in order to promote reconciliation, cohesion, and national healing.
There's one way out of this political crisis, and this is the constructive dialogue. The national dialogue will be directed at difficulties of the elections, the reform of the electoral process, national healing and reconciliation, criteria for addressing long-term issues of governance, transparency and accountability, poverty, unemployment, economic inequality, conflict resolution and injustices, among others.
During a mass that was celebrated earlier in honor of the late Eldoret Diocese Bishop Cornelius Korir, the men of cloth urged politicians to emulate the fallen cleric, pleading with them to tone down their rhetoric and instead foster peace and unity.
This situation, if unchecked, leads to more hatred and mistrust, which could easily lead to anarchy and breakdown of social order. That political leaders must stop their reckless utterances and hate speech that are inciting people to violence. Our leaders stop calling others names, stop the politics of division and ethnic profiling.
The calls come at a time when the National Super Alliance has renewed its narrative on secession of parts of the country. The NASA coalition has also announced that it will resume protests on Friday. In a letter to the Nairobi police boss, the coalition said that it will hold peaceful demonstrations to protest what it termed as electoral impunity in Kenya. Perhaps learning to speak up in times of crisis, after coming under heavy criticism for not offering direction to Kenyans, it appears the clergy are now taking their positions as a voice of reason.
Stop the agitation for cessation, because all is not lost.
The clergy are also calling on the security apparatus to exercise restraint in their efforts to deal with protests.